A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 3rd April, on the front page you have Congress promises to create wealth, ensure welfare for all. So the manifesto has been released by the Congress and it commits to provide ₹72,000 annual income to poorest families. So it's plans for the agriculture sector, for the youth. On Rafael, it says the procurement of Rafael fighter jets and other deals under the BJP government will be investigated and anti-corruption laws will be enforced without discrimination. And even on national security, it says national security advisor and national security council will be accountable to parliament and their powers will be defined under law. Chief of defense staff will be made principal advisor to government on matters related to defense. It also calls for review of laws on crimes like lynching, etc. On agriculture also, it says farmers will be put on the path of Karz Mukti, means loan waiver, to Karz Mukti, means freedom from loans. So rather than waiving the loans after they have been unable to pay, making them free from loans. So that, you know, they should get remunerative prices, there should be lower input cost and access to institutional credit for them. So he says a separate Kisan budget will be presented every year. Then this is RBI circular to banks on loan defaulters quashed. So this is regarding the Supreme Court now striking down the RBI circular giving lender banks 6 months to resolve their stress assets or more under the insolvency code against private entities. So this has been quashed by the Supreme Court. So this was for private entities who have defaulted on loans worth over 2000 crores. So this is very important, the Feb 12, 2018 circular of RBI. So it had actually nullified all other resolution processes for stressed assets. It said banks would get 6 months to resolve their stressed assets or they have to move under the insolvency code. But the private companies, they approached the Supreme Court and they said that if this 180 day or 6 month limit is applied to all sectors without going into their special problems, then it would treat unequals equally. And that is why Supreme Court has now struck down the RBI circular. Okay. Then below you have enzyme to curb bacteria cell growth discovered. So scientists at the Center for Cellular and Molecular Biology have discovered an enzyme which helps in breaking cell walls of bacteria. So this offers a potential for the new drug delivery route to arrest the antibacterial resistance of the existing antibiotic drugs. So we have seen antibiotic resistance is a huge issue. So if the bacteria cell walls can be broken down, then there can be this drug delivery route to the bacteria and this antibacterial resistance can also be tackled. So it is said it is crucial to know how cells grow in bacteria to understand the antibacterial resistance to currently available antibiotics. So scientists all over the world are trying to understand this. So actually in this process what is being done is that the enzyme which works on cell division, which is called a scissors enzyme, that is blocked. So that helps bring down the cell walls of the bacteria and this will actually help in understanding antimicrobial resistance in microbes and the antibiotic resistant drugs can also then prove beneficial. Then on page 7 you have Pakistan airspace closure hits Afghan, Kazakh, Russian airlines. So this is regarding how Pakistan has closed its airspace. So thousands of passengers are likely to face longer flights and pay higher fares now. So we had discussed this earlier too. So post the Balakot airstrikes, this is the step which Pakistan has taken now and planes are being rerouted, which is resulting in longer flights as well as higher fares. And this is starting May, ISRO to launch a string of defense satellites. So launch of few Earth observation satellites have been advanced too. So the details of these launches which ISRO is expected to make in 2019-20 is given. So you should know the communication satellites are the GSAT satellites, geostationary satellites. Then the satellites which are these Microsat R, which is also there, and EMISAT which has been launched earlier. So HYSIS was launched in November, Microsat R, EMISAT, these are all defense satellites. satellite. Cartosat 2 is a high resolution imaging satellite. Then here you have Indian space debris may have doubled after mission Shakti. So NASA is tracking risk to International Space Station from 24 pieces now, and you can see the space debris in orbit and out of orbit for various countries is listed here. So India also has space debris because those unused satellites etc. become debris in space. Then this is Election Commission pulls up Railways, Air India over model code. So Election Commission has expressed displeasure over lackadaisical approach of Air India and Railways in enforcing model of code of conduct. It has sent a show cause notice to the Civil Aviation Ministry for using the boarding pass bearing Prime Minister Narendra Modi's photo. So this issue has come to the fore. Even the Railways, you know, the allegations that tickets carried Mr. Modi's photographs and paper cups bear "May Bhi Chowkidar" slogan were used in the trains. Then this is early brain functioning affected in poor kids. So this is a study which has been conducted by University of East Anglia, and it says that students from lower income backgrounds have weaker brain activity. So, their mothers also had a low level of education. Such children have weaker brain activity and were more likely to be distracted. On the editorial page, the first editorial is poll time censorship. So this is regarding the gag order which has been obtained by Bengaluru Lok Sabha candidate. So it says this defies freedom of speech. So Bengaluru Civil Court has put blanket over restraining 49 newspapers, television channels and other media outlets from publishing anything defamatory about Tejasvi Surya, the BJP candidate for Bengaluru South Lok Sabha constituency. So of course, this is said to be contrary to the law and the constitution. And below you have Turkish surprise. So the ruling party's losses in local polls are a personal setback for the Turkish president Recep Tayyip Erdogan. And the lead article is the many and different faces of terror. So this is regarding Islamic State. It has been defeated in the Middle East, but it is said it is premature to read the Islamic State's defeat as the start of a more peaceful phase. And this is how to achieve 24/7 power for all. So this suggests three steps to help rural India overcome electricity poverty and reap immense socio-economic benefits. So this discusses this issue. So these three steps discussed are: first, India needs real-time monitoring of supply at the end user level. So what is the supply at the end user level should be monitored. Second, it says distribution companies, DISCOMs, need to focus on improving the quality of supply as well as maintenance of services. And finally, it says improvement in supply should be complemented with significant improvement in customer service, which includes, you know, other aspects like you can see, you know, billing, metering, collection, etc. So these steps will help in ensuring that electricity poverty as such, or electricity, is available to all in rural areas. So there is also this scheme, household electrification scheme, Pradhan Mantri Sahaj Bijli Har Ghar Yojana or Saubhagya scheme. So now every household should also get electricity. So though it has been a success and it has been achievement, but last mile connectivity is still an issue. Then on the opet page you have, is there genuine change in Algeria? So this is regarding how Algeria saw protests, you know, public protests demanding Algerian president stepping down, who had ruled for 20 years. And the president has now announced he will leave office. So this is something similar to the Arab Spring, which was seen some few years back. So this is now a question raised, is there genuine change in Algeria? It says the Algerian protesters appear to have learned the lessons of the Arab Spring. So Arab Spring was when many such long time rulers were made to step down. In various countries like Egypt, Tunisia, they all came under Arab Spring, the Middle Eastern countries. Tunisia, Algeria are in African continent. Then, but they are Arab nations as such, as you can see. Then this is the principle and procedure in Lokpal. So this article says that it is disappointing that the appointment of the Lokpal was shrouded in secrecy. So the entire history of Lokpal and background of members is discussed here. And this is regarding the MGNREGS cut, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act. So the reducing funds for MGNREGS has caused disenchantment, it says, among two groups which are politically powerful. So the households have been affected, the farmers who are the main beneficiaries of this, poor villagers have been affected because of this cut. And it is said also many of the laborers in MGNREGS work sites have been women. So women have also been significantly affected because of this, along with villagers. Then this is continuation of the front page Congress manifesto. And this is RBI order on defaulters lagged government notes, it says Supreme Court. So this is again regarding the same Feb 2018 circular of RBI. Then this is on international page, there is no important news except regarding Brexit, which we have seen. So now steps will take place for further Brexit extension. So when that news comes forth, when that happens, we will discuss it. Then again on the business page is the same issue on Supreme Court verdict on RBI circular, Feb 2018 circular. So it says it could delay resolution of stress assets. So prospects of recovering 3.8 lakh crore loans is uncertain, it is said. Lenders can still refer case to National Company Law Tribunal without citing February 12 circular, says bankers. So this is the further detail of the Supreme Court ruling and its after effect. And this is breather for a sector choking with stressed assets. So power sector has been a major sector with stressed assets, and now it is said bankers will get time to finalize the resolution plan for about 13 gigawatts of power projects. And this is regarding jet resolution plan. So it says jet resolution plan hits turbulence because Supreme Court decision may derail this scheme too. 15 more planes of jet have also been grounded now. On page 14, you have manufacturing PMI at a 6-month low. So effect of strong demand, receipt of bulk orders have been hit by competition. So this is according to the survey that, the private sector survey, Nikkei India Manufacturing Purchasing Managers Index. So it has gone to a 6-month low. It has seen expansion, but it is at a low. It is of 52.6 in March. So this is said to be due to lower level of new orders and production. So it is said in February it was 54.3 and now it has reduced to 52.6. But a reading of above 50 implies expansion, while one below it denotes contraction in activity. Then there is no important news on the last page. For detailed coverage of current affairs, there is a current affairs full video which is prepared. You can visit our website asha.com and get the details of this current affairs course as such too, in which these daily videos are provided. Plus also you can download the current affairs PDF. So PDFs on a daily basis are made available. So those can be downloaded here too. So that is it. Thank you.